Because I'm happy. I'm a Muslim, that's what makes me happy, and that's the truth. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 190, that fight against those who fight you, but do not transgress, for Allah likes not those who are transgressors. Allah says in Surah Baqarah chapter 2 verse 193, that fight until there is no more tumult and oppression. Islam is against oppression. And even when we do qital, there are certain guidelines laid down by Allah and His Messenger for qital, that when you have to fight in self-defense. Almost all were in self-defense. There are guidelines laid down that when you fight, do not chop trees, do not hurt the women, do not hurt the old men, do not come in the battlefield, do not kill children, do not break down monasteries, do not destroy the temples. Today you find in the all bombing, everyone, women killed, children killed, men killed. If you compare in the complete history of Muhammad, there were 82 encounters taking place, and 1,018 people were killed. In World War I, more than 10 million people were killed. In World War II, more than 20 million people were killed. Compare this. Today, as I said, media is very powerful, can convert black into white, day into night. When the Christian nuns, when they cover the head, they are respected. When Muslim women cover the head, then they say Islam degrades the woman. Why? When the Sikh wears the turban and keeps a beard, he is called religious. When Muslim wear a cap and keep a beard, he is called as a fundamentalist, terrorist. Why these double standards? I would like to end my talk by replying to the allegation of the media that Islam was spread by the sword. And it's a common allegation laid down by the international media that Islam was spread by the sword. The reply to this allegation is given very well by a famous historian by the name of Delisi O'Leary. He mentions in the book Islam at the Crossroad on page number 8, Delisi O'Leary says, history makes it clear that the legend of fanatical Muslims sweeping across the world, forcing Islam at the point of the sword over conquered races, is the most fantastic, absurd myth that historians have ever repeated. I would like to repeat the statement of Delisi O'Leary, the famous historian. History makes it clear that the legend of fanatical Muslims forcing Islam at the point of the sword over conquered races is the most absurd, fantastic myth that historians have ever repeated. When we read history, we come to know that we Muslims, the Arabs, they ruled the Arab lands for the past 1400 years. For a few years the Britishers came, for a few years the French came, but as a whole, the Muslim Arabs were the lords of the Arab lands. Yet today, there are more than 9 million Arabs who are Coptic Christians. Coptic Christian means they are Christians in generations. These 9 million Arab Christians are giving shahada, are bearing witness that Islam was spread by the sword. We Muslims, we ruled India for about 1,000 years. That time India was the most powerful country in the world. The Mughals, the Muslims. If we wanted, we could have forced every non-Muslim to accept Islam at the point of the sword. We didn't do it. Today, in India, more than 80% of the Indians, they are non-Muslims. These 80% non-Muslim Indians, they are giving shahada. They are bearing witness that Islam was spread by the sword. Today, the largest populated Muslim country in the world, it's Indonesia. I'm asking the question, which Muslim army went to Indonesia? Which Muslim army came to Malaysia, which has more than 55% Muslims? Which Muslim army? Which Muslim army went to the east coast of Africa? Which sword?
We would tell beautiful things by this man, Prophet Muhammad, may peace be upon him. He taught us to love and to care for each other. That is the sunnah of the chosen one. Loving for your brother, what you love for yourself is so true.